Welcome to the Defense and Aerospace Report. I'm Vaga Maradian here at the Reagan National Defense Forum at the Ronald Reagan Presidential Library in Simi Valley, California, where our coverage is sponsored by Leonardo DRS and L3 Technologies. And we have with us Lithuania's Defense Minister, Raimondas Karoblis. Sir, great seeing you again. We saw you in Halifax. You're here at the Reagan Forum as well. In that brief time, the Russians have seized Russian fishing, seized Ukrainian vessels in the Sea of Azov. What does this incident tell you? What are some lessons you take, and how should the alliance be thinking and responding to this, given that it's the latest provocation by the Russians in this crisis area?
Yeah, it's continuation of Russia's aggression in Ukraine. Let's be about that. It's not a single and local incident. It is possible to look through this point, actually very technically only. But from the really political side, it's clear that it is the act of aggression. First time Russia is on Russia's behalf. All acts before that were so they used this aspects of, let's say, green man or actually the card of separatists. First time was on Russian behalf. And secondly, of course, it's the attempt to enforce the Crimea annexation. So violating, of course, this main principle, of course, because of annexation of territorial sovereignty, territorial issues, and also violating the principles of the sea law about the openness of the sea, about the openness of navigation, but also the bilateral treaty, which is formally valid between Russia and Ukraine, about the navigation, so in Kerch Strait. So this is the set, and we definitely should not look at this as a technical and a local incident, and really some adequate consequences should be because of such Russia's behavior.
I want to ask you about the Trident Juncture exercise, but during the Trident Juncture exercises, there were reports that the Russians, for example, were jamming GPS signals over the Baltic. Can you talk to us a little bit about that and the potential danger associated with actions like that by the Russians?
Yes, it's the reflection that Russia want more, they are using the means of electronic warfare. And yes, there were attempts, of course, of jamming GPS, but I think it's actually one of the episodes, I would say. But generally speaking, also we discussed this issue within Nordic format, so probably Russia was relatively calm during Trident Juncture exercises. So compared with the skills exercises which we have, so not overreacting. This we did not see too much increase of the activity on cyber, on information propaganda aspects. Actually, also it was quite, normal. No big escalation. Of course, Russia reserved some areas in the Nordic Sea for the exercises, but it was used only in one area. It's also so probably not too intensive. GPS was one of the episodes, but really for us it was the question why Russia was quite calm, and what will follow after this pause. And after this pause, we see, of course, continuation of the escalation and aggressive behavior against Ukraine.
Let me ask you about Trident Juncture. It was obviously an Article 5 demonstration. All 29 NATO nations, but also Sweden and Finland, which are EU nations, participated in it as well. Talk to us a little bit about some of the lessons learned, because Lithuanian forces also were a key part of the exercise, given that it was something that was in your neighborhood.
Well, I would not like to speak more about lessons learned, I think, but just about the main elements which we have and about the role of Trident Juncture. First of all, it's the biggest NATO and partners exercises since the Cold War, which is really important from the deterrence point of view. It's not about, it's one aspect number, but other aspect is the mobility, which is also really very important. And that really mobility works, and also the involvement, of course, the traditional issues of the interoperability and testing the command and control aspects. And my understanding is that it's really was quite good performance, and also the involvement of all domains of the of the allies and armed forces, starting from land forces, which is really very important, then sea and the aircraft. And one of the seriousness of allies, including of the United States, was the deployment of President Truman aircraft carrier. It was, of course, very, very important assets. Also, the importance of the exercise from the United States was also the deployment of the aircraft President Truman was all the assets, and well, in general, it's well demonstrate that well NATO is analyzed, they're adjusting to the new security situation. They are back to conventional methods in Europe, was adding new elements, which is mobility, and of course that we should continue this exercises in the area, be it in the north like Norway, or our region. Also this year we had quite big anaconda exercises, first of all in Poland, but also continue in Baltic countries. Have in mind in autumn. And of course, we are looking for the exercises in 2019 and the biggest exercises in 2020 in the region.
And one last briefly, did you see anything in Trident Juncture that changes your strategic modernization program at all?
Not at all. Well, we continue with our plans. But, well, Trident Juncture exercises and exercises which are in Lithuania, that really we are on the right track by this modernization, that really the principles which we have, this increase of maneuverability, increase of fire capabilities, and the increase of in intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance, they are right. We really need to continue with this well conventional elements, and well we continue to have the support from the society, we continue to have support from the politicians. First year we are reaching first time 2% from the GDP, and also this year what was important, that agreement of political parties represented by the parliament that to continue with the modernization, continue with increase of capabilities, and even further increase of financement up to 2%, 2.5% till 2030. So we will be so in the same situation as Poland, and being among the leaders of dynamics and the financement in Europe.
Defense Minister Raimondas Karoblis of Lithuania. Sir, it's always a pleasure. Thanks very much. And next time I'll talk to you about NBA basketball.
Okay. I also will prepare myself more about NBA basketball.